Yes, sir, it's visible.
So we are going on the slideshow now, sir, directly.
स्लाइड शो नहीं हुआ डॉक्टर.
सर अभी हो रहा है. हेलो
यस यस डॉक्टर
हेलो.
यस यस
देर इज सम इंटरनेट प्रॉब्लम बट लेट विल गो विद दिस ओनली. ओके सो विल स्टार्ट आवर लेक्चर्स फॉर टुडे व्हिच इज द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी इन जिमनास्टिक. So please, what is the flexibility mean in a gymnastic, or what is the flexibility in day-to-day life? We have a lot of experience regarding the flexibility. We always say that our flexibility is less. We say that our flexibility is more. But what is a flexibility? Flexibility is the ability basically to move our joint in a full range of motion with the ease or without any pain or without any, first of all saying it does not mean that somebody has a good flexibility one in one joint. It means that he has the flexibility in other joint also same, or it might be a different, it might be a less sometimes, it might be a more sometimes. For example, hum dekh sakte ki hamare elbow joint mein jo range of motion hoti hai wo 140 degrees tak hoti hai. To 140 डिग्री तक अगर हमारा जॉइंट पूरा जीरो डिग्री से फुल एक्सटेंशन से जीरो डिग्री से जा रहा है तो हम बोलते हैं कि उसको फुल रेंज ऑफ मोशन है. दैट मींस आवर एल्बो इज फुल्ली फ्लेक्सिबल. इसका एग्जांपल अगर देखा जाए तो हम एक्सटेंडेड मींस फुल जहां से हमारा ओपन किया है हमने एल्बो और वहां से अगर हम लेते और बेंड करते हैं देन वी कैन से दैट यस द जॉइंट फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी एट द एल्बो जॉइंट इज नॉर्मल और इट्स गुड. बट इन जिमनास्टिक व्हाट वी रिक्वायर्स दैट लिटिल बिट ऑफ एक्स्ट्रा काइंड ऑफ अ फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी टू अचीव अ ऑप्टिमम लेवल ऑफ द स्किल्स. सो जिमनास्ट रिक्वायर्ड दिस काइंड ऑफ अ flexibility significantly over here, and it is an absolute one of the tool for the judges also to mark the mark their points also, and if the flexibility not to the mark, may gymnast get a deduction in his elements also. So what are the factors influencing in a flexibility, or what are the factors which really affect basically though? हम देख सकते हैं कि यहाँ पे बहुत सारे ऐसे फैक्टर्स भी होते हैं जो हमारे फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी को या रेंज ऑफ मोशन को अफेक्ट करते हैं. कि जैसे कि हम देख सकते हैं कि बोनी स्ट्रक्चर, जिनके बोनी स्ट्रक्चर्स ज्यादा तो हिंज जॉइंट में है या फिर बॉल एंड सॉकेट जॉइंट में है, वहां पे हम देख सकते हैं कि द रेंज ऑफ मोशन इज मोर इन दैट पर्टिकुलर जॉइंट वेयर द जॉइंट आर मोर फ्लेक्सिबल. बट समटाइम देर इज अ जॉइंट स्टिफनेस और देर इज सम प्रॉब्लम्स वेयर दिस range of motion affected, and ultimately our flexibility of affects also. There are some other factors like age. As we grow, our flexibility comes down because you know that the muscle gets stiffer as the age also grow, and that's what reflects in our range of motion, that it decline, and hence the flexibility also decline. Again, with the gender, we are see more in the women's, they are very flexible than men's. Okay, or females are more flexible than male because they have some kind of hormones in their body, or the laxity is, or the suppleness in their body is more than the male because that's the physiological type of their body. Then we can see about the characteristics of some tissues, where you can see that the tendon or the soft tissue or the fascia, they are a little bit of a stiff or adherent or not move more of the their limits. There also, because of the tightness, we get that the flexibility hampers. Then important factor is also activity. As we are more active, our flexibility is more. Some people tends to inactive. If you compare to the gymnast or compare to the other individuals, they are less flexible than the other. The important point where I want to mark you is a genetic component, a newly research found in genetic component that we have found in a research that two type of genes or genotypes are important in a hypermobility or increase in the mobility of the joint. That is COL5A1 is the gene is generally related to the hypermobility or hyperflexibility and COL5A1CT genotype, which is one of the genotypes which increases your joint laxity and composition of collagen factors also. Now, what happened in this? If you are having this kind of genes already and you choose the field of a gymnastic, definitely you will do well in this particular sports or a particular game, because you have genetically or a God-gifted flexibility in your body. So again, genetics is an important role in flexibility also. Then some structures, passive structures, we comes with the bones, ligament and joint capsule, which are not in a capacity in ours to change. It may be changed with the surgery or something, and they do limit our flexibility as they get kind of some abnormality over there. Also, the active structures, we can say in the gymnast, flexibility is corporate a bigger load, like muscle, tendon, which is attached to the bone. As the length of the muscle increases, the range of motion also increases. But and also not least, nervous system also. We know that the structure which is stretches is nerves, then your muscles and ligament, which also gives you the improvement in your flexibility of the body. So come to here, we can say ki, what is flexibility? If you define these particularly in a scientific language, it is an important thing that the intrinsic property of a bodily tissue which determines the maximum range of joint mobility without resulting in an injury. That means ये हमारी body के अंदर के tissue के अंदर की एक capacity है जो हमारी range of motion और maximum ranges बढ़ाती है, जहाँ पे हमें ऐसा लगता है कि ये रेंज ऑफ मोशन की वजह से फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी बढ़ रही है, लेकिन वो फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी कभी कभी हमें इंजुरी में भी लैंड अप कर सकती है. तो हमें इंजुरी में लैंड अप ना होते हुए इसको बढ़ाना है, एंड दैट्स व्हाई राइट की विदाउट रिजल्टिंग इन एनी इंजुरी. सो देयर आर सम अदर कंपोनेंट्स ऑल्सो ऑफ दिस फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी, एंड दीज आर द components are mainly divided into three parts. Two parts. One is the dynamic stability and second is the static stability. But static stability is further divided into two parts, that is active flexibility and a passive flexibility, or it is directly called as a static active flexibility or static passive flexibility. So what is our dynamic stability? So we can see here the dynamic stability too is the perform with the kinetic flexibility. Kinetic means motion, with the movement, with the motion you have to move it. It means the ability to perform dynamic or motion stretching to bring our limb through its a full range of motion. That means हमें उसको पूरा हमारे range of motion में जितनी उसकी limitations है उसके अंदर लाना है in a dynamic flexibility. Static active flexibility, also called as active flexibility, what to do in this, that basically when we lift a leg and keep it in any other external support, okay, but it's supported with only with your muscles, that called as a static flexibility in this particular gymnast which we are comparing here. One international Russian gymnast, we say Indian gymnast, this is called as active flexibility, where she is doing 180 degree split without any support, but she is balancing a ball very perfectly. It means her own muscles are supported in this particular element. That's called as a static flexibility. And in a passive flexibility, the ability of extending or stretching position of particular muscle and maintain it with using either a external support or either a weight or either apparatus like a chair or a benches, which you take external support or other supports to maintain it also. For example, split is an absolute perfect example for this. So if you go for the passive flexibility example, Manoj sir, can you kindly hello
yeah yeah yeah
can please kindly play the video first video of please play
aapko screen sharing band karna padega fir main chalata
sir kar pa raha yes just a moment yes okay
okay
तो
फर्स्ट वाला सर
फर्स्ट वाला स्प्लिट यस इसमें आप देख रहे हैं कि शी इज डूइंग अ स्प्लिट ओवर हियर एंड शी इज मेंटेनिंग इट आल्सो वेरी वेल सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द एग्जांपल ऑफ अ पैसिव stability here she can use a chair also two chairs also or two benches also to maintain it or to further go into the increase and that will be an absolute example for a passive flexibility sir please stop your screen sir
doctor we have some questions also so
sir you can take a question if you want still I am sharing my screen
okay so we have questions from like first question is how to improve dynamic flexibility but I know that this is the next chapter
yeah
but dynamic, question is how to improve dynamic flexibility
dynamic flexibility is a flexibility which has to increase with the motion or the movement and for that you have to undergo some kinetic movement drills or a dynamic movement drills for example swinging your arms okay or knee to chest positions continuously doing or high knees drills when you are doing at the ground so these are continuous movement which help you out to stretch you dynamically theek hai sir
okay sir I think understandable and the one next. Question is how can we find our out about col5a1 in gymnast
सर मेरे आगे के पीपीटी में मैं आपको बताऊंगा कि हाउ कैन वी आइडेंटिफाई लैक्सिटी और फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी इन यंग जिमनास्ट बट इट इज टोटली लैब रिसर्च टेस्ट वेर वी कैन फाइंड आउट फ्रॉम द जेनेटिक लैब्स दैट वेदर वी हैव दिस काइंड ऑफ जीन्स इन पर्टिकुलर जिमनास्ट लाइक हम बहुत बार ऐसे देखते हैं कि फास्ट ट्विच फाइबर्स रहते हैं वाइट फाइबर्स और रेड फाइबर्स रहते हैं जो शॉर्ट ट्विच फाइबर्स रहते हैं उनका जो जिम में रिसर्च होता है उसमें पता चल रहा है कि यस ही इज गुड फॉर द फास्ट ट्विच फाइबर्स और ही इज गुड फॉर द स्लो ट्विच फाइबर्स ही इज अ वाइट फाइबर पर्सन और ही इज मोर ऑफ द रेड फाइबर पर्सन फ्रॉम दैट ओनली यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड द जीन्स टाइप ऑल्सो विद द लैब डिटेक्शन ओनली जेनेटिक लैब डिटेक्शन दैट ऑल्सो
डॉक्टर साहब हम एक क्वेश्चन और ले लेते हैं हमारे चीफ कोच अशोक मिश्रा जी ने दिया है व्हाट इज द फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी एंड मोबिलिटी डज आर द सेम और एनी डिफरेंस
नो देयर इज अ लिटिल बिट डिफरेंस इन फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी एंड मोबिलिटी फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी इज द एबिलिटी टू फ्लेक्स टू बेंड और टू अचीव अ फुल रेंज ऑफ मोशन इन दैट पर्टिकुलर जॉइंट इन फैक्ट मोबिलिटी इज द कंपोनेंट वेयर you do your maximum or achieve your range of motion maximum range of motion with the movement in whole body or whole particular that part where you wanted to exercise it or you wanted to train it so mobility is a phenomenon is different and flexibility is also different but yes flexibility is helping to increase your mobility and mobility is depending on the flexibility so mujhe aasha hai ki maine आपको आपका आंसर दिया है सर अगर कुछ है तो आप मनोज सर को या फिर साई साई सेंटर में आपका
अगर कुछ आएगा तो मैं आपको बताता हूं सर आपने दिया आप आगे बढ़ सकते हैं सर
हां सर सर हम इसमें कुछ ड्रिल्स देख रहे हैं मेरे स्क्रीन पे शेयर हो रहा है
व्हाई इज द डायरेक्ट नहीं हुआ सर अभी
नहीं हुआ है जस्ट अ मोमेंट हेलो
या डॉक्टर साहब नहीं
हुआ सर
स्क्रीन शेयर नहीं हुआ सर आपका
नहीं हुआ है सर जस्ट अ मोमेंट
बस स्क्रीन शेयर करते करते सर बता दीजिए, इज देयर एनी पर्टिकुलर एज? ओके
सर बोलिए.
चलिए सर, एक क्वेश्चन आया था सर, इज देयर एनी पर्टिकुलर एज टू इंक्रीज फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी फॉर बॉयज एंड गर्ल्स?
Yes, yes, it's a very good question. Whoever asks is, there is particular...
Sachin Tupe, sir. From Sachin Tupe.
From Sachin. Thank you, Sachin, asking this question, which is very important. To achieve a flexibility is, till that point, you can do it where, when person is in active mode. Again, in active mode, or he's doing his training. But if you go with the chronological age or orders, it is still in a boy, still you can go to 20 to 25 years. In a girl, it will go to around 16 to 20 or 22 years. Basically, from their adolescent age till they become, a grown person. That particular time you can go. There is no specific age, but yes, with the efforts, anybody can increase their flexibility. But there are some limitations, physiological also and anatomical also. Which I also told that some factors affect in my previous slide, that these factors affecting in that bone joints age, particularly activity and all, that also we have to consider. Hope I answer your question, Sachin. Thank you very much for asking question. Can we go further?
Yes, sir, please.
So there, if you see in my screen, there is a person is doing lunges, is actually an active movement video, but it's not moving. So if you see, this is the person who is doing the dynamic flexibility drills, which is doing the dynamic lunges over there. And he's in all the lunges, if you see, he is going and increasing his range of motion as decreasing his angles and trying to touch to go till the ankle range. So this is one of the dynamic flexibility drill you can have for an example. Then we have a passive flexibility in that also. If you see this picture where the another person is helping to the gymnast to stretch his limb, this particularly to increase the range of motion at the hip joint from the hamstring stretching, because as you get a length in your hamstring, you definitely increases your flexibility at the lower limb. With the external support of person or any other elevated surface also, you can do it. In this, you can perform an isometric contractions also, and which will help you increase your length or maintain your length of the hamstring muscle. The another example is again a example of a static flexibility, where you just do your toe touches and use your body weight or body resistance to stretch your muscles. So why flexibility is important? Anybody can have any questions regarding this, sir?
कोई क्वेश्चंस है इसके रिगार्डिंग कि फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी क्यों इम्पोर्टेंट है, तो आप प्लीज लिख दीजिए. यहाँ पे आया है सर, सर इज देयर एनी राइट एज ऑफ स्टार्टिंग फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी एक्सरसाइज इन चाइल्ड, हाउ मच लोड टू बी गिवन इन स्टार्ट?
आई विल आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन आफ्टर द सम टाइम, बिकॉज दिस इज कमिंग इन अ प्रिकॉशंस ऑल्सो. बट यस सर, यहाँ पे हम ये कर सकते हैं कि जिमनास्ट का फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी करने का एज मिनिमम 10 ईयर के या 12 ईयर के आसपास हो, तो हमें फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी अचीव करने में ज्यादा आसानी होती है, और कुछ फिजियोलॉजिकल रिफ्लेक्सेस और चेंजेस से वो बॉडी में अकर होना शुरू होते हैं.
ओके सर,
सो फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी इज इम्पोर्टेंट बिकॉज इट्स अ नीड ऑफ अ जिमनास्ट. इट्स जिमनास्टिक्स मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम डिपेंडेंस ऑफ द फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी, बिकॉज वेन जिमनास्ट वॉन्ट टू अडेप्ट a certain specific position in order to perform their skill or mastery in it, you require more of the flexibility. As much as you are flexible, you are able to get your optimum level of a flexibility, so you will get more points in your competition by the judges. Because if the gymnast does not perform a split leaps at the angle which is required to have the gymnastic skill, there are chances of deduction are more, or you can say vice versa. There is a possibility of a deduction if the gymnast is not able to do a split leaps at the optimal level of requirement by the gymnastic sports in the competition. For this, you need to be exhibit how flexible your joints, in particularly in your hip joints, in your shoulder, in your vertebral column. If you have any stiffness in this particular joints, definitely your flexibility hampers. For shoulder flexibility required for bridges, backhand spring and hip flexibility required split jumps and leap. So it is very important that you have shoulder flexibility when you are performing your bridges or backhand spring, and you require a hip flexibility when you are doing your splits and jump leaps also.
Manoj, sir. Yes, I have one question.
Please, yes.
Dr. Sandeep, you have any data?
Hello.
Gymnast will get more marks in competition?
Sir, can you repeat this question, because I'm not able to hear you.
You have a data or research that if a gymnast have a more flexibility, he will get a more marks?
Sir, no, I haven't have any data, but if it is available in research, definitely I will send it to SAI authority, and you might be have, but till now we don't have any data. But yes, when you execute your element, your flexibility component is do considered by the judges, and that will give you the more points, optimum points in your difficulty levels of the element.
But I am in a gymnastic from the last 30 years. I have not seen any one case where you have a more flexibility, you will get a more marks. Because okay. Marks will get only on difficult levels, element difficult.
Sorry okay. to interrupt, sir. Okay. May, doctor, on the behalf of you, can I say something?
Yeah, yes, sir. Sure.
पठानिया सर, यहाँ पे जो हमारा एक वो आ रहा है उसका ये है कि जो हम एलिमेंट परफॉर्म करते हैं वो एग्जीक्यूशन, जैसे हमें टो पॉइंट करना है तो टो पॉइंट करने के लिए हमें टो का फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी और स्ट्रेंथ का जो कॉम्बिनेशन होता है उसके द्वारा हम मूवमेंट करते हैं, तो वहां पे वो एग्जीक्यूशन में फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी इन्वॉल्व होती है और वहां पे हम पॉइंट बचा सकते हैं. Maybe am I right, doctor?
सर हाँ, मुझे भी यही कहना था कि जब हम एलिमेंट करें, जब हम आप एलिमेंट्स करवाते हो जिमनास्ट के साथ, तब वो डिफिकल्टी लेवल्स जो आपको अप्रिशिएट है जिमनास्ट से, आपको लगता है कि इतने लेवल पे होना चाहिए, वो अचीव करने के लिए हमें ज़रूरत होती है फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी की. और अगर आपकी फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी ज़्यादा हो तो आपका एग्जीक्यूशन वेरी स्मूथली परफॉर्म होता है, एंड यू डेफिनेटली गेट अ गुड मार्क्स व्हेन यू परफॉर्म योर डिफिकल्टी लेवल वन हायर लेवल देन द अदर एथलीट अदर जिमनास्ट. Sir. So I think I have given the answer also, sir. So can we go further?
Yes, sir, please.
Sir, there are types of stretching also you very well known to this type, like dynamic stretching, active stretching. We have some passive stretching also. Then we have isometric stretching also, and we have a PNF stretching also. In that, we just go through from the flexibility. But I have one question for all of you that. We were talking about the dynamic flexibility also, and now we are talking about dynamic stretching also. Is there any relation or is there any difference in this? Manoj sir, aap bhi answer kar sakte iska.
Sir, main koi bhi coach agar sir Pathania sir aap ki flexibility aur stretching mein agar koi puchna chahte hain ki koi bata sakta hai explain what is the difference between flexibility and stretching?
Stretching is a first part of flexibility. Initial stages, it is we can say it is a stretching,
and after very good, sir. Sir.
I think you got your answer, doctor.
हाँ, मैं मेरा आंसर मिला है सर, लेकिन मैं थोड़ा सा इसके ऊपर क्लेरिफिकेशन करूंगा.
देखिए,
जैसे कि हम लोग एग्जाम में जाते हैं तो हम मेमोरी प्रिपेयर करके जाते हैं, मेमोराइज करते हैं, कोई पार्ट पढ़ के जाते हैं और हम एग्जाम में लिखते हैं, और उसके बाद हमें एग्जाम में जो रिजल्ट आता है वो हमारे मार्क्स होते हैं. तो वैसे ही यहाँ पे भी बोला, अगर हम अप्लाई कर सकते हैं कि स्ट्रेचिंग इज अ प्रिपरेशन टूल और स्ट्रेचिंग वेर यू हैव टू डू इट रेगुलरली, ओके, और उसका रिजल्ट है आपको आपके फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी में मिलता है जो इंक्रीज होते हैं. तो फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी इज टोटली डिपेंड अपॉन द स्ट्रेचिंग, रेंज ऑफ मोशन आपका इंक्रीज होगा, उसके वजह अदर स्ट्रक्चर्स ऑल्सो गेट स्ट्रेच लाइक मसल, टेंडन, योर नर्व्स, देन लिगामेंट्स, नियर बाय एरिया यू हैव द फेशिया ऑल्सो. That fascia also gets stretched, and automatically you get increased range of motion at that particular joint joint area, and then you will get it result in your flexibility. That when you assess it, you will find out that yes, the flexibility is increased. So this is a very close relation in between. They are interdependent. You can say flexibility is dependent upon the stretching stretching and that's why we are asked this question also to you people that yes there is if any clarification. So jo basic level mein coaching kar rahe unko bhi iska fayda hoga ki agar stretching zyada kiya to definitely we'll get a more flexible flexibility in gymnast. So we are going further. Yes, there are different type of stretching. In that you have a dynamic stretching. How will you do it? It is a moving parts of your body and gradually increase the reach, speed of the movement also, or sometimes you have to do both. You have to move your body parts also and gradually increase your speed also. And automatically you are seeing drills also over here in the image that they are performing for a dynamic stretch. So it is nothing but stretching which consists of a controlled leg and arm swing or a movement to take you or a joint to the limits of your highest range of motion or full complete range of motion. But remember that there should not be any bouncing movement or any jerky movement, otherwise you will land up with some kind of injuries. And for example, we have some arm swings, or we do a leg control leg swings, or we do a torso twist. This kind of stretching comes under a dynamic stretching. In active stretching, we know all, most of we also do many time for the active stretching for our any warm up stretch, warm up drills also. In that you can see that we are bringing our leg up high in a as much as degree possible to us and hold it and stretch it. This kind of stretching calls in a active stretching. And here we have many of the yoga poses or yoga stretching poses, which is the example of your active stretching. Passive stretching, where you comes, is also called as a relaxed stretching. Also, it's very important for the gymnast, where you have assume a position and hold it with the some other part of your body, or with the assistance of your partner or any apparatus like chair or benches. As shown in this figure also, when she is doing a split or increasing her speed, she is helping out with the two benches and getting passively stretched for the increase range of motion at the hip and groin level. So it should be also a relaxed and useful in a relieving spasm, because hame bahut slowly or relax karna chahiye ye passive movement, because we are in the maximum or optimum level to stretch our muscle fibers also. And that time if it is in a fast, you might be land up with any injuries. So that's why it should be in a very relaxed and slow movement, and as much as able or able to increase your duration, you can increase in this also. Yahan pe maine ek question main khud puchna chahta hu ki we are saying that in some times of this passive flexibility you can have spasms also. So Manoj sir, aap bhi answer kar sakte hai ya koi dusra bhi kar sakta hai?
Sir, aap bataiye question kya hai, main puchta hu sir.
The question is that when we are doing stretching, basically a passive stretching, sometimes okay, we get a cramps or we get a spasm. So why it is happens?
Okay, koi iska answer karna chahega please, ki jab hum passive stretching karte hain to spasm kyon aata hai ya wo kyon ho jata hai, koi karna chahega please? Anyone interesting, please message me. Anyone? Kanaliya sir,
Manoj
sir,
when we are going for passive stretching, jo relax kiya hai, so I think there is a no chance for cramp, because we are going for relaxation.
Yes, 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 absolutely right sir. When we are doing a relaxation, there is no chances of any spasm. But if you are doing in a hurry or you going in a fast, hello,
yes doctor, please carry on.
When you are doing in a fast or you are doing in a hurry, there are chances of spasm, because what happened here, the stretch reflex comes across and it sends the abrupt movement to the brain started a protective movement to save or protect that particular part, and that's why we land up with the spasmodic particular reflex in that area and we get a spasm. So agar aap hurry or if you are doing in a fast movement while doing your passive activity, then it will land up you in a spasms also. So here we have another example when we are doing a passive stretch for a gymnast, a hamstring passive stretch with the help of the other person, where he is able to support him to get more stretch his hamstring muscle and get more range of motion at that particular joint.
Okay. Sir, passive flexibility से और इससे related मेरा question है, बड़ा common है sir.
हाँ sir, please.
अभी coaches के behalf पे ये पूछना चाहता हूँ doctor.
हाँ जी sir, हाँ जी sir.
कभी ये अपना under process था कि अभी mostly gym में जाके क्या होता है, हमारे बच्चे आते हैं without warming up अपने straddle करके बैठ जाते हैं gyms में.
हाँ.
तो is this like in a right way or it will harm? क्योंकि मैंने कहीं पढ़ा था कि अगर हम direct without warming up आगे stretching खोल के बैठते हैं, जैसे कि हमारे बॉडी में दो तरह के फाइबर होते हैं, स्लो ट्विच फाइबर एंड फास्ट ट्विच फाइबर, एंड जिम्नास्टिक इज 80% एनारोबिक स्पोर्ट्स, सो क्या ये हार्मफुल है या ये आपका जो चल रहा था अंडर कंस्ट्रक्शन या अंडर प्रोसेस उसमें कुछ है इम्प्लीमेंटेशन उसके बारे में सर कुछ बताएंगे प्लीज?
हाँ सर, अभी नए इम्प्लीमेंटेशन इसमें आ रहे हैं, अंडर रिसर्च अभी भी ये है टॉपिक, लेकिन ऐसे बताया जा रहा है या ऐसा है कि जहाँ पे आप अगर वार्म अप एरिया में आ रहे हो तो यू शुड कीप योर सेल्फ एक्टिव and activated your brain also with the muscle body part, with so it will get to the go to the your fast twitch muscle fibers, and if you in a reset mode or you can say a rest mode, you are not able to achieve the optimum level of stretching or optimum level of warm up if you have a rest or in that particular area. Instead of that, you should do small calisthenic movement or you do some kind of a dynamic stretching, so it come keep you on a go or on an activity level, so your fibers doesn't your muscle doesn't get rest and it is in an active mode, so you'll get more stretchability, more flexibility, or you can able to get more skill level increase in that particular gymnast. So I will advise that they should not be rest, but they should be busy in some activity of a warming up activity, so it will be helpful for in them to further activity.
Thank you, doctor. Thank you very much.
Welcome, sir. Next, we are coming on the important topic also, which is the important part of stretching called as isometric stretching. Isometric stretching means it's a self-explanatory also that it doesn't require any motion. It iso means same and metric means in a measurement also same. So when you do this particular stretching, for example, which I show in my example of this photo also, that when she is keeping her leg up on the external support and stretching it out, she is doing isometric stretching, but in that she has to push down her heel, so her hamstring muscle will get stretched in isometrically, so there is no change in the length also there is no change in a length also, and there is no kind of a movement, but yes, there is a heavy or a strong contraction comes in your muscle, which help you to get your muscle stretch better. And here are some examples also where you have a calf stretch, which is very commonly done in gymnastic arena also. You see that gymnast is able to move and stretch his walk with the help of the stretching calves, with the help of the wall also, or sometimes he does a chest isometrically stretch also with the help of the bar. So these are the some examples which for the isometric stretching. Now it's very important that what precaution should we take. There should be a precautions while doing isometric stretching, and it is not recommended for a children and adolescent whose bone are still growing, because the growth plate has to be settled down, and they are still increasing, so it will hamper and it might be affect your growth plate also. So there will be some abnormal pathology or abnormality will come across. But in gymnastic, again, with the precautionary measures, again, I'm saying it is my personal opinion that with the precautionary measures, you can definitely tell your gymnast to do isometric stretching, okay? Because it helps also to achieve an optimum contraction level in your muscle and increase your range of motion at that particular joint also. And the second point is also very important, that people are usually already flexible. In gymnast, what happened? The people are more flexible and they have a strength also good enough to do a stretches. But when the isometric contraction happens, there are they are in the higher risk also to damage any tendons or a connective tissue, and they get internal any muscle injury also. So when you are doing this isometric stretching, little bit careful, or it should be do in a proper observation with the guidance of coach or a fitness trainer. So let's come in again one of the important and important stretching in previous days called as ballistic stretching, but nowadays it is little bit you can say neglected, or it can be, you know, hamper your movements due to its make you more prone for the injury levels. So Manoj sir, can you on a video,
please sir, you just stop sharing your
video of hamstring stretch, ballistic stretch.
Yes sir. Kicks. You want kick, na doctor?
No sir.
Hamstring.
You can on that also. Then we can go for the ballistic hamstring. Okay. Kick so one, sir. Also. This is also one example of a dynamic flexibility or dynamics exercises with kicking. Kicking happen at the hip region, and you can have this commonly do with your gymnast in your gymnastic practice or training session also. Sir, now ballistic hamstring stretch.
Okay, sir.
So this is called as a ballistic stretching also, where you have a small bouncy or movements, continuous movement, where you do the drills and try to touch the ground levels with movement front. That will help you to ballistically stretch your hamstring and muscles nearby your hip also, and the muscles of your trunk also. So this comes under ballistic stretching. Now we'll see the another video which also in a ballistic stretching area. So please, sir, third one. Here also a kicking video, side kicking videos where you can see a ballistic movements, and she is going to do that. So here you can see the speed and the bouncing of the movement is more. Sometimes they can, you know, if they are not conditioned well or trained well, they can prove more injuries in that particular areas of the hip. So ballistic is little bit, you know, stretching which keep you more liable for injuries. So this is my again a personal opinion that try to avoid these movements. Thank you, sir. Can you stop your sharing so I can share the PPT? Can you able to see the
yes sir
screen? Yeah,
yes doctor.
So here it is. Here it is, we saw this videos where we have this ballistic stretching, and it's a says that it's a bouncing movement or out, which gives you in a stretch position, which stretches your muscle in a direction or in a level that the springy movements happens, and that predispose you more for the injury. And that's why I says that it is not stretching is not considered as useful for the gymnast, because it may lead to injuries while training also. We'll go further. Some examples are here in ballistic stretching. If you see, these examples are toe touch to the ground. It's basically stretches your lower back, hamstring, and some movements of a chest swinging or chest flaring movements for the stretching of the chest or a pectoral region of the muscle of chest and a shoulder joint also. So here we come important topic, which is called as a PNF. Many of you are aware of proper PNF stretching, but can anybody explain or highlight on this, on a PNF, what you know, so I can explain more on that.
Actually, sure. Doctor, everybody is mute, so.
Okay, sir. I will explain in the PNF session. Important in, see, many of having a fear of this PNF stretching, but PNF is a very simple stretching method. If you understand the basic component in this, basically it is a proprioceptive neuromuscular facilitation. तो इसके नाम में ही आपको इसका महत्व क्या है, इम्पोर्टेंस क्या है पता चलता है. प्रोप्रियोसेप्टिव मींस द सेंसेशन व्हिच कम्स फ्रॉम योर जॉइंट, इट्स कॉल्ड एज अ प्रोप्रियोसेप्शन. दिस रिसेप्टर आर मेनली सिचुएटेड एट योर जॉइंट लेवल, जैसे एंकल जॉइंट है, नी जॉइंट है, हिप जॉइंट है, इन दैट एरिया यू हैव मोर प्रोप्रियोसेप्शंस. बट न्यूरोमस्कुलर, इट हैपेंस एट द जंक्शन लेवल ऑफ अ न्यूरोमस्कुलर, मींस एट द लेवल ऑफ neurological and at the level of muscle, and it gets facilitated. Facilitated means motivated. So you give some sensation which is a coming from your joint to your neuromuscular junction, and motivate that reflex to get a signals or a better signal or a motivational or a excited signals to happen. The movement which is happen over there should be happens very smoothly and very effectively. So this PNF is very important stretching for us nowadays. It is commonly done in all the fitness area or all the fitness fraternity, that they go more now for a PNF stretches. So we can see here is currently fastest mode of effectivity also, and increased static and passive flexibility both. As I told you, that is a synonymous of a proprioceptive neuromuscular facilitating music. Motivated or excited our neuromuscular junction with the help of our proprioceptors. Post isometrically, you can say, post training session, it is done morely in a several sports also nowadays. And PNF refers mainly to post isometric relaxation stretching techniques, in which muscle group is passively stretched, then contracts isometrically against resistance while in the stretch position, and then is passively stretched again through the resulting increased range of motion. So yahan pe main ek simple example de dunga PNF kaise work hota hai. It is basically a hold relax, then contract relax, and contract relax with the agonist, means supporting muscle support, agonist muscle support. You do this particularly jaise ki kabhi kabhi hamare peer group mein ya senior हमारे साथ वाले हमारे फ्रेंड के साथ झगड़ा होता है, तो कभी कभी हम लोग उसको होल्ड करके रखते हैं, तो थोड़ी देर हम लोग उनसे बातचीत बंद करते हैं, तो वो होल्ड में रहता है. उसके बाद हम क्या करते हैं, कोई पहल करता है कि नहीं मैं बात करूंगा या वो बात कर रहे हैं, इसी तरह से कोई पहल करके वो बात होता है, तो होल्ड एंड रिलैक्स. सो अगर द कम्युनिकेशन और द एफर्ट्स ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन बिकम वेरी स्मूथ, एंड लास्टली नॉट दैट वी हैव टुगेदर इफेक्ट टू गेट मोर स्ट्रेचिंग एफर्ट और मोर कम्युनिकेटिव इफेक्ट पर्टिकुलरली with both the friend, so one get relaxed and one supported also for that particular communication. So it is the stretching which depends upon the post isometric relaxation, hold and relax techniques. Okay, and here you can have this video also, so you can clear your concept also with this gentleman. Manoj sir.
Yes, hello. Sir. Please.
Can you share that video?
यस वीडियो शेयर करते करते सर मैं क्वेश्चन पूछना चाहता हूं. मेरे पास आया है मिस्टर सुनील छेत्री कि हम पीएनएफ मेथड जो स्ट्रेचिंग है वो वीक में कितनी बार कर सकते हैं और क्या ये इंटेंस वर्कआउट के बाद कर सकते हैं.
सर
पीएनएफ एलोबरेट आफ्टर दिस वीडियो.
हां सर श्योर.
PNF is stretch, resist, again. against the stretch and then relax and stretch it further, okay? That's different than reciprocal inhibition. We'll talk about that in our next video. So again, PNF stretch is contract against my stretch and then relax and we stretch it further. Contract, relax, that's it, okay? So the most basic one is our hamstrings because it's a large lever that we can think of and we easily know where the hamstrings are on somebody. So I'm gonna have you place your legs down flat on the table here. And with tight hamstrings, PNF stretches always make the tight muscle do the work. So PNF is contract and relax, and it makes the tight muscle do the work. So if the hamstrings are tight, they're going to have a resistance with going and stretching this way. And right now with Christy, we have right about there is her end range. And how we tell again is when this knee starts popping, bending like that, then we need to relax it. So here, and it, let it go. She can get way further, okay? Versus if we try to stretch her out right here, see how the leg remains in that kind of bent position till right about there. So the contract, relax portion, the first thing we always do is go to the max range of motion. For me, this is very unstable, so I'm gonna put all of my body weight behind it, just like this. Now I can creep up closer. I can creep closer, and this way, that's about in. Are you comfortable with that? Okay, so she is comfortable. I know that I'm stable now, that I have this against my body. So basically all that we're gonna have her do is we're trying to stretch her that way, she's gonna push that way. So Christy, with 10% of your energy only, it's just a matter of making these muscles right here contract, not trying to push me over or anything. You're gonna use 10% of your energy and you're gonna resist your foot down towards the table, so bringing your entire leg down. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Okay, good. So now that she knows what she's supposed to do and I've shown her, hey, this is the movement, I'm gonna go ahead and do it. So Christy, what I want you to do is just follow my directions as I count it down with this stretch, okay? Awesome, take a nice deep breath for me. On the exhale, go ahead and start contracting, push right on through. A little bit more push if you can. There you go. And then I feel that she's pushing deeply enough. Keep breathing for me. There we go. And I watch the rise of her hand, just making sure that she's breathing. We got 8 more seconds. 7, 6, 5. Keep breathing. Keep pushing. 4, 3, 2. Take a nice slow inhale again. On this exhale, I want you to just relax it. Relax. Relax. We move at that point when we say relax into our new range of motion. Now this looks a little bit easier. See, her leg does not do the knee pop this way, so that's good. Now I let her go back down to neutral and I bring it back up again. It'll be just a little bit less because it's not in that uber lengthened position. So that's PNF stretching over the hamstrings. One more time, we'll do that. All right, Christy, what I'm going to have you do is I want you to resist directly down with your foot. So you're going to bring your foot all the way down like this, or your leg, I should say. And you're only going to use about 10% of your energy total. That's all that we need, okay? All right, good deal. Take a nice slow deep breath in. On the exhale, go ahead and start resisting against me. Perfect. Yep, keep breathing, keep pushing. We got 10, 9, 8, 7, 6. Keep pushing. 5, 4, 3, 2. Slow deep breath in. On the exhale, just relax it slowly. Right there. One more deep breath in for me.
Doctor, please tell me where I need
and
to
all go. The way out. And I see if this is, it's about her next
stretch. That's it. How many minutes are finished?
Really flexy people, we hold down here or at the hip. And we can push way further. We're not going to do that though because these little guys don't want to do such a thing. Right? So that's PNF stretching. Contract and relax.
Now you can stop, sir.
Yes, doctor. About PNF, I have a question. Like I said, Mr. Sunil Chetri want to ask, how many times in a week we can do PNF? And can we do after intense training also?
Sir, yes, you can absolutely do after intense training because it needs to be do after intense training only. So, aap jab intense ya zyada intensity level high rakke jab aap training karwa rahe ho, uske baad PNF stretching karna recovery session mein bahut zaruri hai because when you have come from an intense level, it get you in a recovery mode. and get your muscle more stretch and get back to the normal also. So you are at the optimum level to get good stretching from your muscles and a joint also. तो हाँ सुनील जी, मैं आपको मेरे ओपिनियन से एडवाइस करूंगा कि आप हमेशा ये जरूर कीजिए कि जब आप इंटेंस वर्कआउट कर रहे हैं अपने जिमनास्ट के साथ, तब इसके साथ आप पीएनएफ स्ट्रेचिंग को भी इंक्लूड कीजिए। दूसरी बात, आपने मुझे पूछा है कि वीक में कितने बार हम कर सकते हैं, तो टोटली डिपेंड्स अपॉन योर ट्रेनिंग सेशंस। बेसिकली इट इज हाउ मेनी टाइम्स यू डू योर ट्रेनिंग सेशंस इन अ वीक। इफ यू आर डूइंग ट्रेनिंग सेशंस इन अ वीक अल्टरनेट डे, इट इज 3 times in a week also is fine. But if you are in a periodization session, just आप off season में हो और आप एक gymnast को उसके अगले competition के लिए तैयार कर रहे हो या ready कर रहे हो, उस time पे आपको इसको 4 to 5 times करवाना है week में। और आप जब competition time पे हो तो उसको reduce कर से फिर से उसको 3 times or 4 times आपको week में लेके आना है। So I think sir, I have clear his both the questions. So we yes, can go further.
Yes, sir. One question over, sir. How do we determine the right posture for doing passive stretching of the muscle fiber, alignment to the muscle fiber?
Can you repeat, sir, question?
Sir, how do we determine the right posture for doing passive stretching to align of muscle fiber?
Vinod ne bhi question pucha, bahut acha question hai. इसमें ये जरूरी है कि आपको हर स्ट्रेचिंग में पोस्चर का ध्यान रखना जरूरी है। पोस्चर शुड बी इन अ न्यूट्रल और अ नॉर्मल अलाइनमेंट ओनली। इट शुड नॉट बी समवेयर मोरली एलिवेटेड और मोरली एंगुलेटेड, और कहीं पे जैसे हम नॉर्मली पोस्चर स्ट्रेचिंग में देखते हैं कि किसी की पेल्विस टिल्ट हो रही है एंटीरियरली, या किसी का पीछे पेल्विस टिल्ट हो रहा है एक्चुअली, किसी के नीज बेंड हो रहे हैं बीच में ही। सो दैट इज नॉट गुड बिकॉज इट विल नॉट गिव यू द एग्जैक्ट इफेक्ट ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर स्ट्रेचिंग। तो मुझे ऐसा लगता है कि जितने जैसा हो सके एज मच एज न्यूट्रल पोस्चर, मैं बार बार बोल रहा हूँ न्यूट्रल, नॉर्मल नहीं, न्यूट्रल पोस्चर, सारे जॉइंट्स एनाटॉमिकल लेवल में सही लेवल पे होने चाहिए, उसका पोजिशन सही लेवल पे, जो नॉर्मल अलाइनमेंट है एनाटॉमिकल पोजिशन ऑफ द बॉडी का उसके हिसाब से होना चाहिए, एंड देन यू कैन डू अ स्ट्रेचिंग। But in gymnast, sometimes to get more range of motion or achieve more flexibility, you need to get alteration also in a flexibility. But in that also, that the alteration should not hamper your posture or should not give any problem or cause any injury to your posture. वो precautionary measure के अंदर आप करवा सकते हो।
Thank you, doctor.
ठीक है sir.
Very much. Thank you very much. The question from Sohan Patade.
Thank you, Sohan. Can we go for sharing my screen now, sir?
Please, sir. We have we can go 10 minutes more. It's 12:55, yes, and the time is 1, so we can go 1:10 maybe. So please.
Yes. So, sir, can you able to see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Here you go. What happens with this? Stretching, flexibility, what's happened actually? So there are a lot of changes happen at the neurological level and the muscular level. But as the changes which happens at the muscular level, you can see or you can assess, but neurological level also, there are a lot of changes happen, which is we coaches or we even a clinician also unaware. And the research that says that when you do a regular stretching or consistent stretching, the muscle tissue and the fibers are get increase in their length. And it is how it is increased, because when you stretch it out, the muscle length increases and be a constant for some particular time or some particular duration. So they adopt for the new length. Like humne abhi baat kiya tha ki gymnast bhi adopt karte hai flexibility level increase, flexibility level increase limitation to increase their skill. Waise hi muscle bhi apne adopt karte hai levels, and it comes by the slowly changes you can see in the muscular and the neurological level. Waise jaise muscle increase hota hai length mein, waise hi nerve increase hoti hai apne level mein, aur uske fibers bhi stretch hote hai, uska length bhi badhta hai. So you get a good lengthened nervous system also, and which is helping in a reduction of a threshold for a stretch reflex. Otherwise, what happens, our stretch reflex always comes in a picture and it gives abnormal signals of a pain. So we have to stop our stretching. So if you have a good neurological lengthened structure also, your stretch reflex threshold also reduces within the muscle. Then जो pain pain signal जाते हैं, is called as a nociceptors, जो leg से या limb से या फिर body से जो pain carry करते हैं, उनके sensitivity भी उससे transmit करने का जो ये है वो कम होता है, level कम होता है. They have in a reduced manner to send that signal because they are habitual for this neurological changes when you do consistently stretching. हमारे बॉडी में एनक्लेफाइन नाम का एक केमिकल होता है, वो भी सीक्रेट होता है विच रिड्यूसेस आवर पेन. एंड व्हेन यू डू योर स्ट्रेचेस, इफ द एनक्लेफाइन डू इज रोल, सो यू कैन गो फॉर द फर्दर अचीवमेंट ऑफ स्ट्रेचिंग ऑल्सो एंड रेंज ऑफ मोशन ऑल्सो. एवरीथिंग हैपन्स इन एट आवर ब्रेन लेवल एंड द स्पाइनल कॉर्ड लेवल. दैट्स वाई इट्स इंपॉर्टेंट दैट वी शुड नो अबाउट द सम न्यूरोलॉजिकल चेंजेस ऑल्सो after the stretching flexibility drills. So there are some mechanical efforts also, but we'll not go into the important, but yes, we will let you know about what happened at the muscular level. Is that viscoelasticity of the muscle increases and the amount of a stiffness in the muscle also decreases because of the stretching, and it helps also to sarcomerogenesis, that is called as the lengthening happening in the sarcomere of the muscle, which help us to the get more new length in the muscle or new increased fiber length in the muscle and help to get a increased range of motion or a increased flexibility. So we are coming here, what is important in a stretching and what should do. So you should improve or keep your dynamic stretching as a part of your warm-up because it improves the strength and explosive power, and you need explosive power when you are doing your elements. So I will suggest in my opinion that dynamic stretching should be in warm-up session, and we have a static stretching and a PNF stretching. अभी हमने एक सवाल भी question भी लिया था कि जिसमें उन्हें पूछा गया था कि intense training के बाद करवाना चाहिए ये PNF stretching या नहीं करवाना चाहिए. तो I think that static stretching भी करवाना चाहिए, and it should be in a manner where we can hold around 15 to 20 30 seconds to in a recovery phase to get the effect of stretching on the particular muscle to increase the length in that particular joint area. And the PNF we should increase increase sessions also in our training session, because it's the most effective to increase range of motion, and it helps in a recovery also. So it should be done a recovery phase, but I will strongly oppose nowadays, because it's also research support that ballistic stretching may cause injury in gymnast and athlete. So try to avoid this ballistic stretching. So now we'll come on a flexibility assessment. How we should do the assessment also.
Doctor, can I say something, doctor?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Actually, I got a question from Nirbhay sir. He is our senior coach. That yeah. What are the assessment tests? So मुझे लगता है इन स्लाइड्स में उनके आंसर मिल जाएंगे.
हाँ सर, इसमें हम नाउ अभय सर को आप बोलिए कि हम ऑन द असेसमेंट ही है, एंड आई थिंक ही विल गेट हिज आंसर. ओके, सो हाउ वी असेस द फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी. सो देयर आर सम बैटरीज व्हिच इज हैज बीन पुट अप फ्रॉम द इंटरनेशनल फेडरेशन ऑफ जिमनास्ट, एंड देयर आर दीज फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी बैटरीज और टेस्ट यू कैन डू इन योर जिमनास्ट टू असेस द their flexibility and document it, how much is in the range, how much he is able to do in the duration also. So you are able to assess their flexibility in a day to day or week to week or month to month criteria. So in that you have the side split set, which we have already seen a video also, which I have shown in my previous one slide. And here we have a slight side split, then we have a right side split, then we have here a left side split side, then we have a middle split also, or also called as a straddle split over here. Then we have a bridge also, which we'll see in the next slide also, and active shoulder flexibility done by the gymnast. So you have to have a noted or documented these on the daily basis or a monthly or a weekly basis, or a 15 daily or fortnightly as possible to you. And we can see there are definitely changes happening in the assessment. You can get at least a idea of assessment what happening with your gymnast. Okay, there are some lower flexibility, lower limb flexibility test. Here we have around six tests over here that you can see that test one is saying that supported lower limb hold to the front, means you have to hold your hand in a 180 degree split maximum at near to the your front joint and rear side means more nearer to the ankle. So you can assess with this how your gymnast is going, whether it is at the low level or whether it is at the mid level or whether it is the highest or optimal level. So you can assess with this test also. Then second, you have a supported lower limb hold test in the side. So sideways, how it goes with at the base, mid level or at the highest level or at the optimal level. So you can go in this test also, unsupported lower hold on the front also. Then you have unsupported lower limb hold to the side also. Then supported lower limb hold at the rear means backside and at as much as long to the ankle joint. And if you see these five tests, they all are unsupported first four. It means it is the again an example of a static active flexibility where you are supported and holding your own limb in a such a position where you are not supporting with any other external support and you are able to maintain it also. And the last one is sixth one is unsupported lower limb hold to a rear also. Here also we have at the basic level, then at the mid-range level, at the optimal level and the highest level that can be possible to a gymnast. And the last not but least, the seventh test is for the split. And here you can see the example or the importance of a passive flexibility when it's doing on the both the external supportive, basically on the elevated surface of these benches. And they are trying to get your split more and more flexible. At the basic, then in an intermediate level, then medium or optimal level and the highest level they can achieve. So these are some examples where you can test your gymnast for their flexibility also. And very important is that a question comes in my session also before that, how we understand whether the genetics level are there, are accessible in that gymnast. But so there is simple test if you see this, which is on your screen, that there are some hyperextended elbows, finger hyperextended levels at the perpendiculars. Then you have hyperextended knees or your thumb which touches to your forearm. These are some laxity tests, or you can say a flexibility test, okay, which is, can be done very easily and find out whether the gymnast is flexible or whether the individual is flexible enough to come and do take a gymnastic as a sport. So how should we do a flexibility training? We come on the flexibility training that to protect the gymnast in our care and protect our slip against the possible allegation of poor practice, coaches must carefully consider their actions and how they might be perceived by an observer. Because nowadays when we are training our gymnast, there are parents comes or there are their well-wishers, their friends comes always with them, and they are observing you also, that whether you are able to do that training properly and a proper precautionary and a care manner or not. If you go somewhere wrong also, or somewhere with the harsh with the budding gymnast, then there is a problem that some allegation come across you. So we should have a protocol which is not yet set in a flexibility, but we should follow some protocol while training of flexibility drills. So principle of flexibility means we have to follow some rules. In that, the important rule is must remember that changes in a flexibility come about from a slow, consistent and patient application in training. Again, I'll read for you. It comes from the slow, consistent and patient application in training. जैसे कि अगर आप करवा रहे हो हरी में कर रहे हो या फास्ट इसमें करोगे जिमनास्ट के साथ फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी ट्रेनिंग, तो वो कहीं पे ना कहीं पे उसको जाके इंजरी में लैंड अप करेगा और उसके रिजल्ट नहीं आएंगे आपको. तो आई थिंक दैट हमें स्लो रेगुलरली कंसिस्टेंसी रख के उसको करना चाहिए हमारे, और रियलिस्टिक टारगेट रख के करना चाहिए ताकि हम वो फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी लेवल, वो रेंज ऑफ मोशन लेवल वो एथलीट्स में पा सके। रेगुलरली यूज अ करेक्टिव फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी एक्सरसाइजेस, स्किल्स प्रोग्रेशन, स्ट्रेंथ ट्रेनिंग असाइनमेंट्स बेस्ड ऑन द इंडिविजुअल मूवमेंट एंड असेसमेंट ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर जिमनास्ट टू एंश्योर द प्रोग्रेस ऑल्सो, डॉक्यूमेंटेड इट ऑल्सो फोर्टनाइटली और मंथली। ओके, डे टू डे विल नॉट गेट एनी चेंजेस मच मोर, बट डेफिनेटली आफ्टर मंथ और थ्री मंथली यू विल गेट डेफिनेटली अ चेंजेस इन द फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी। So long term changes also are there in a minimal injury risk. If you want to come across, please do proper flexibility trainings in your gymnast. There are some do's and don'ts where we'll go short of the time we have to wind up it. That's why we are just going some do's and don'ts. Encourage a good flexibility program for the beginner as your children are more flexible, and once good range of movement is achieved, it is easier to maintain them. For a flexibility program to be effective, the gymnast must be always motivated, or he is always rewarded for achieving a good ranges or doing a skill in a optimal level of his possibility. There are some other do's also. The important to maintain a balance between the passive and active stage, otherwise the flexibility changes you will not observe properly. These are some do's which is already on the screen, and already I just go through it. Some don'ts, that yes, I will tell you that don't be unrealistic, keep unrealistic expectation, and don't be a quick fix person in your gymnast. Give them a time, you also take a time, and get a realistic goal to achieve it. So please go through also in your don'ts, and if you have any question, please send across to the Sport Authority of India, and we'll try to give your answers also in that. The important topic here, how also increase nowadays, a foam rolling is very popular amongst the fitness fraternity, and we also insist to do a foam rolling before any warm-up session or any flexibility session or in a stretching session, because here you get a benefit from the foam rolls that your fascia stretch well, you get a optimum level stretching in that particular joint. So I will also advise that you should do a foam rolling regularly. There are some importance and indication and a research done on the female college why the 8 weeks training increases the flexibility in gymnast. So you can go through in this slide also in your PPT already. Then specific flexibility training, how you should do a specific flexibility training. In that, I will suggest you, if you see in this right hand and left hand split, okay? So you should perform it for the 60 second of foam rolling. Pehle aap foam rolling kijiye iske liye, front of your thigh, inner of your thigh, back of your thigh. और उसके बाद 30 सेकेंड्स के लिए, ट्रू मीन्स रियलिस्टिक, ओके, फॉर द रियल टाइम यू शुड डू योर स्ट्रेच, क्वाड स्ट्रेच एंड लेग लोअर स्ट्रेच, सो यू विल डेफिनेटली यू विल गेट अ न्यू रेंजेस इन योर फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी ड्रिल्स आल्सो, इन अ ट्रेनिंग आल्सो, एंड इट विल गिव यू ऑप्टिमम लेवल टू दैट पर्टिकुलर एरिया विद हिज रेंज ऑफ मोशंस। देन startle split also, in that I again insist that 60 seconds of a foam rolling in a inner thigh, back of thigh, and 30 seconds for the thigh rock or half kneeling inner thigh rocks. If you do, definitely you will able to achieve the good startle split. Then overhead flexibility also, you please follow with the 60 second of a foam rolling under arm and chest also. I will advise you for the back also, in a thoracic basically, or in a lumbar region also you do a foam rolling, and keep for a 30 second under grip stick stretch, floor, chest, table stretch, so you are able to increase your stretch and optimum level of your overhead shoulder flexibility also. So sir, I would like to ask you one question. Hello, Manoj sir.
Sir, please.
Sir, मुझे एक क्वेश्चन है, मैंने बहुत बार ऐसे देखा है जब जिम्नास्टिक ट्रेनिंग होती है वहाँ पे, कि जब वो हमारा ओवरहेड शोल्डर फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी करते हैं, वो कौन से लेवल पे करना चाहिए, ये ग्राउंड लेवल पे करना चाहिए या फिर और कौन से लेवल पे करना चाहिए कि उसका इफेक्ट ज्यादा रहे?
सर माय पर्सनल ओपिनियन, जो ग्राउंड, सपोज मैं ब्रिज का एग्जांपल देता हूँ, अगर हमें ब्रिज का एग्जांपल लेना है, सपोज करो हम बिगनिंग में स्टार्ट कराते हैं, अगर हम स्टार्टिंग में ही बच्चों को ग्राउंड लेवल पे कराएंगे तो जिस पर्टिकुलर पार्ट के लिए हमें स्ट्रेचिंग चाहिए वो पर्टिकुलर पार्ट पे नहीं जाएगा। सपोज करो ब्रिज इज अ पार्ट ऑफ शोल्डर फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी, अगर हम बच्चे को ब्रिज ग्राउंड लेवल पे कराते हैं तो वो इम्पैक्ट उसकी बैक पे चला जाएगा ना कि शोल्डर पे। सो माय पर्सनल ओपिनियन कि जब हम स्टार्ट करते हैं तो छोटे बच्चों का जो लेग्स है वो ऑलवेज ऑन अ हायर सरफेस एंड देन हैंड्स इन अ लोअर सरफेस एंड देन वी कैन गो विद द ब्रिज। माय पर्सनल ओपिनियन सर।
हां एब्सोल्युटली सर राइट। व्हेनेवर यू आर डूइंग दिस ओवरहेड ब्रिज योर लेवल ऑफ द ट्रेनिंग शुड बी हायर लेवल, सो यू आर एबल टू गेट अ रेंज टू गेट योर शोल्डर ऑल्सो इन एंड द स्ट्रेच विल बी डायरेक्टली कम ऑन द शोल्डर कॉम्प्लेक्स, नॉट विल बी ऑन योर स्पाइन और लंबर रीजन। So you will get a stretching effect or a flexibility effect more on your shoulder than the other. Then now we have some drills over here, which is for the training exercises for specific in a flexibility. If you go through this, all the walks I have given and I explain in the picture formative also, and you can see this is of all four walks. Then we have a caterpillar walk, then we have bear walk. We have a rabbit walk also, which is a small drills which will help you to all or improvement in a flexibility from your shoulder, hip, ankle, knee and spine also. So these are some drills I have given. Now the benefits of flexibility training is that you will get a increased range of motion, improve your performance, reduce of risk of injury at an optimal level, then reduces your imbalance, then you are able to increase your body awareness also and get a prevention in the chronic overuse injury because of the training also. Here I will be very thankful of all the dignitaries of the Sport Authority of India and my colleagues also which help me over here.